I'm a monologuist. I create shows that are nonfiction, that actually happened. And in the theater, I think that's a radical act, to actually make something on stage that is not illusion, to actually tell stories of places that are real and things that actually happened. And I am bringing to Berkeley Repertory Theater two different monologues, contrasting, that are both about journeys. The first of the two monologues is called The Last Cargo Cult, and that show is about two things. The first is my journey to a small island in the South Pacific called Tana, and on that island, they have a celebration one day a year where they worship the culture and history and objects of America. And I went to this island, and I was there for their celebration. I celebrated with them, and in the course of the show, I talk about their religion and their belief system, how these objects become totems to them of power. And that's contrast with the second storyline, which is about the international financial collapse that affected all of us all over the world, and it draws connections between both these worlds and what money means to all of us in this culture that we're embedded in. That's the first story. The second show is called The Agony and the Ecstasy of Steve Jobs. And that show is principally about Steve Jobs and Apple and industrial design. It's about Jobs' rise and fall and rise. It's about the idea that in this age now, if we control the metaphor through which people see the world, then we control the world itself. It's also about these beautiful devices and where they come from. And I went to Shenzhen in southern China, where almost all the electronics in the world are made. I went there to investigate Apple's business practices and the business practices of all electronics makers, where things are made under brutal conditions that are, frankly, shocking even to people, I think, that believe they know how their objects are made. Both these storylines sort of weave against each other to try to tell a comprehensive story about these objects that mean so much to us and the ways in which they came to exist. All the details are there at the website, berkeleyrep.org.